Hi guys, so let's begin. So first of all, let me introduce myself and then we'll jump to next thing. So those who raise hand, I just want to tell you that guys, you have to drop the message in the chat because I cannot unmute any one of you. Second thing is, okay, let me introduce myself first of all. So I'm Akash. I'm basically based out of London. My complete background is in the full stack development. So I'm not only the, say, a developer. Basically, I'm working as a solution architect. So my role is here justifying the things that we're going to talk about today. How come basically, as being a solution architect, my role is to see what all things are going in market, what are new, how I can secure my application, how should I do the new things in the application. So these are the things that I have to on daily basis. That's my job. Okay. Now, apart from that, so today we are going to talk about the cyber security. And one more thing I want to tell you guys, there's a one thing called we have one page called Meetup page of Edureka. So today is the first webinar of this month we are starting. But just to tell you, we have around 170 webinars this week, means that this coming month in this September, we have around 170 webinars. Okay. So out of all these 170 webinars, if you want to get a list of them, if you want to get a notification of them, you want to see what all things are we going to cover, so I recommend everyone to follow the us on this, join this group or the Meetup page. On this Meetup page, you will get notification if you subscribe for the webinars. If you just click on attend, you will get a subscription, and there you can see what all webinars are going to happen this month. And not this month, every month we are doing around 100 to 150 webinars on the different topics. Okay. Now let me start. So cyber security. So cyber security is referred to something, everything digital. So what happened? Like these days, everything means you see around, say your surrounding, you'll find out starting from your grocery to the electronics. Okay, I don't see anything which nowadays we have to go in person and get the things from there. Everything is in our hand, means online, means everything is going online. Our bank transactions, our Paytm, or say a lot of things are there in India, right? To do the money transfer or Google Pay, a lot of things are there. So everything that we have is related to security. Why so? Because everything need to be so secure. Suppose you say you're doing a transaction, right? Now somebody try to penetrate that and get your password, you will be hacked. So nowadays, see, applications for one thing, you'll find 100 of the application. Now those are now companies, instead of focusing on the new development nowadays, companies are actually focusing on the security. Why? Because they want their application as secure as possible. If you have noticed the websites of bank, okay, they are very simple. Means if you see them as compared to other websites, they are very simple. Why simple? Because that website are not meant to be fancy. Okay, that websites are designed to be secure. So their main aim is not to make it fancy. Their main aim is to make it as secure as possible, because if the website is secure, that makes sense, that give confidence to the users. So that is why guys, these days, no, this security has raised up to the very high extent that company have already started expensing lot on the security. So these days the job of security market is going very high. That's the reason, because applications are there but they are not secure. So if I talk about the security, so if you remember few days back, the Apple Cloud got hacked. I'm not sure you guys are aware of that or not. Apple Cloud even got hacked. Sometime back, Sony database got hacked and they went in a big loss because lot of copyright movies and all got leaked, if you remember that. So it's not a point that everyone is say, even the big companies are getting hacked. So that is why company are spending now a lot on their security because that's their prime thing. Now, our agenda is we're going to talk about something network, why cybersecurity, the CI tried, vulnerability, threat and risk, and cognitive security, cybersecurity. So first of all, we'll talk about the network part. Now, on the network, suppose there's some things are present on the network. Now, what we have to do, basically, we have to write a mechanism to download that file. Now, when the file is transferring from here to here, it's on the network, right? Now, anybody try to penetrate this network, they can get your file. That's a hack, right? Now, so what? How exactly it go? So basically, every data that is transferred right now, I'm talking to you also, you are seeing this PPT, every data is transferred in the packets. Earlier days, I'm not sure you guys have seen those things or not, when we downloaded a 2G or 3G networks, no, those days back in Nokia phones, there we say 10 packet download, 12 packet download. What is that? Actually, everything sent in a packet. Nobody send a stream, nobody send a complete data in one go. Why? Because it's heavy, second thing threat. That is why everybody focus on sending the data in the packets. So contain the critical information regarding packet. The information include things like source address, destination address, type of service, IP and version, a lot of things. So this sending part have two things. Packet have one thing called packet header. Packet header. So that's what, it's like a node. It's like a first node which is connected to send the data. And then we have the payload with that. So payload refer to actual data being contained in the packet. This could be anything ranging from media, executable file, or even a simple text file. It can be anything. So in short, we can say that everything sent as a packet, packet have two things, one packet header and a packet load. Then what we have? The packet header actually contains a lot of things. Version means when we send the IP, you know, the two protocol, one is called IPv4 and one is called IPv6. The two different protocol in which people use, for the more secure they will use IPv6 and normal website run over the IPv4 network. Then it has length of the entire IP address. Then they have differentiated service code point that refer to type of service, means what kind of service we are doing. Then we have ENC. So congestion notification means suppose packets are transferring, right? How much packet speed they are doing, how much load is there, is it going to send in a one go, is it going to take some time, that all decide by this ECN. Then we have total length, entire IP packet include IP header and IP payload. Now there must be some way to identify that. So if IP packet is fragmented during the transmission, all the fragmented contains some identification number to identify original IP packet belong to. So suppose something got break. You must have seen what happened when we are doing the data transfer, right? Suppose, okay, you must have seen your Chrome browsers. What happened to Chrome browser when you're transferring the data? At that point of time, sometime in the below of the Chrome, when the things are actually downloading, so they have an option to stop and resume. How they identify that at what point, what all packets are received and what all packets are going to come. So that's come from this identification. Then we have flag. So it say as required by the network source, if IP packet is too large to handle, these flag tell that fragment or not. Means more fragment of that packet need or it will go. So I'm telling about this IPv header, whatever things are sending, there's so many things are in IPv header. Means if one packet even got hard, no, your so much information is going to leak. So fragment offset, the offset tell the exact position of a fragment in the original packet IP. Means is a 10th packet, 12th packet, 13th packet, like that. Then we have TTL, time to leave. To avoid looping in the network, every packet sent with some TTL. So sometime what happened? Download happened, right? At 30%, it stopped. But it's not like at 30% stop and never go forward. Actually, when it stop at 30%, it will not wait for an unlimited time. It wait for only some amount of time. After that, it say fail because you're right now, your connection is open to receive that packets, but you cannot keep it alive always. So ultimately, you have reached a place where you will close your packets. Then we have protocols, means how your data is going secured or not. So you must have seen that we have protocols by which tell the network layer destination which protocol packet belong to, means HTTP, secure, SSL, FTP, what kind of it is. Then we have header checksum. This field is used to keep entire checksum value of entire header, which is then used to check if packet received error free or not. This will give the notification. Yes, we have received the package. Then source IP, destination IP, and anything else if particularly somebody want to send in the header. Okay. So that means one small header contains so many things. So that is why, guys, say if one packet got lost, no, over the network, means you lost lots of information. Now, there one thing called as OSI model. OSI model. Now, what is that OSI model stand for? Open source interconnection model. This is called as open source interconnection model. So it can say that it's a conceptual model that categorize and standardize the communication function of telecom or computer system without regard to underlying internal structure technology. So basically, it's a kind of a layer that we have to follow to send the data over the network. Means it have a proper layer, is a proper say segment which will tell that how data is going to be transferred over the network. Means what are the say first level, second level, like that. Then now this OSI model have some layers like physical application layer, presentation layer, session, transport. It go in the opposite direction, means start from physical, go from data link, then network, then transport, session, presentation, and application. So first of all, any network start with physical layers, means always the first thing that start will start from the physical location. Then the physical instrument is there that always start the things. Then we have data link over which the data will start transferring. Then we have a network. Then we have a transport part where we'll say how data is going to transfer. Then we manage the sessions. Okay, then we manage the sessions. And then we have the presentation layer from where we are going to receive it. And then we have the application layer. So this is how exactly any data transfer from physical location to the main location. Okay, so that stands for OSI model. So okay, there is where the user application sits and need to transfer data between or among the host, for example, HTTP files or anything. Then what happened? This layer helped to understand data presentation one form or host to other host in their native representation. Data from sender is converted to on the wire data and the receiver, and it convert to native presentation on the receiver data. Means when we say we are talking over this LAN, okay, now whatever data you have, that data anyways need to be transferred in the form of say sent to the wire, right? Unless or until not sent to the wire, how are you going to transfer that? So that is why first of all data will transfer over the wire. Okay. And the one who is receiving that, it automatically convert back into the main data. Then we have session. Now what this session will do, the layer provides session management. Okay. This layer provide session management. So anyways, we have to manage the session, because only after managing the session, then we can see that how, because you are talking, you have to maintain one session, because with that session only, you have to get the idea how data is getting transferred. Means when you logged into Facebook, right? At the time of logging to Facebook also, you have to say, not logged in unlimited time, right? After some time, it automatically logged out and asked you to log in. Nowadays, they keep, if your system is there, if you have to do the two-way authentication, multiple level of authentication, then nowadays they don't log out. But ultimately, session got expired after some amount of time, and then we have to again retrieve that session. Okay, so that is how session layer goes. After that, transport layer, network layer, data link, and physical. So that's what the OSI model. Similar to OSI, we have TCP/IP model, where we have application, then transport, internet, and link. So whatever data is going over the direct network, like TCP/IP connections, that go in this format. So I don't know. I want to mainly come to now the security part of this. So I'll come to next slide. We'll show you the security part mainly. Now here I'm showing, we are just showing you how exact data will start transferring from one location to other location. That is called broadcast. Means, so you see your YouTube, right? YouTube is more like a broadcast. Means it's loading from one place and coming on multiple system. That's like a broadcast system. Now, so what exactly happened when you visit the Google? So when we actually visit the Google, on that Google, what we do is, we have three-way handshake. So what happened? First of all, it go to the system, to the internet. Okay. Or client will call the internet. Then data will be sent to the server. Server will return back the data, and that again received by the client. So client to internet to server. So this is a form any data happen. So ultimately client have to send some token. Okay. Client will send some token. Now that's a kind of a authentication, that's a kind of verification, because when a client will send some token, on that token particularly, it will try to validate that. Okay, on that token, it will try to validate that. And so that's a kind of a handshake happening here, because here we have to wait for one connection, and then we'll wait for the response of that connection. Okay, so that's how any network connection happen over the system. So what's my computer address? So first of all, see, every network or every system have their own IP address. I mean, if you check in my IP on the Google, if you type simply, you'll find out everyone have their own IP address. Okay, everyone have their own IP address. So over that IP address actually will connect. Then you have your IP address and MAC address. So both the thing into map. So computer A have the IP and computer A have the MAC address. So how anybody know from where this message is coming? Basically, we have to send it over the network. We'll send it over the network, and network will tell from where this data is coming. Okay, so these are the kind of a layer that so we have to make to get the things. So that generally we try to make a direct communications of if a middle layer. Why so? Because if you have middle layer in between, then what actually happen with those middle layer, does vulnerability increase? Why so? Because obviously when somebody is there in between, the network has a hop, and when network has a hop, so automatically that will go down. That is why it's always good to have a, say, not a middleman. And for the security purpose, we have something called firewall. Okay, we have one thing called firewall. Now what is that firewall?
firewall is something. So everybody, you must have seen what happened. These days when you start installing something in your system, and one more important thing, these days we don't have the antivirus in our systems. Did you notice recently? Nowadays, we don't have antivirus in our systems. Why so? Because nowadays we have firewalls. Every system has firewall. Earlier days we have to keep the antivirus in a system because that make the things in that way. But nowadays that things are gone. So mainly we don't have firewall antivirus. Now we implement a firewall. Firewall is a network system that monitor and control overall your incoming and outgoing network traffic based on advanced and defined set of security rules. So packet firewall, application firewall, or hybrid firewalls. So when packet receive, first of all, that sending the header. Now see, it will receive as a firewall. If that authenticated from the firewall, those packet which are valid, that will go. Those packet which are invalid, that will be blocked by the firewall. So that is how exactly things goes. Guys, those who are raising hand, I'll request you to drop the chat because I'm unable to unmute any one of you. So basically drop in a chat if you have any doubt. It's open, you guys can drop in a chat. I can answer your doubts. Now, what else for cybersecurity? So one by one, what is the application firewall? Application firewall is a security system that protect network resource by filtering message at the application layer, and proxy firewall may be called an application firewall or gateway firewall. So basically these are firewall that we have to call whenever we are talking to any of the system. Okay. And what is hybrid firewall? So hybrid firewall is a combination of application and packet firewall that are applied in series. So that's kind of firewall is called hybrid firewall. So we have application firewall and a packet filtering firewall. So these days that our networks are actually following this kind of firewall, hybrid firewall. Now, so if you put them in parallel, there are two ways, like you are putting them in a parallel or you are putting one beside the other or using one of them, that you have to decide. That's how actually these days we secure the system mainly by this way, using these firewalls. Another way, cryptography. So cryptography is associated with processing of converting ordinary plain text into intangible text and vice versa. It is a method of sorting and transmitting data in particular form so that those for whom its intent cannot read and process. So what happened when we transfer? So I'm not sure you are guys from a proper coding background or not. These days we have JWTs. JWT for the authentication. What is that? Basically, nowadays when we send a security key or password, we'll try to authenticate that. How exactly authenticate? We'll actually authenticate it by the way of cryptography. We'll convert that string or convert that thing into the coding, into the code that the one who know how to decode, they only can see that thing, but no other one see that. There are a lot of things, MD5 hash or SHA-256. There are a lot of kind of encodings are there, a lot of kind of cryptos methods are there by which we'll actually encode our data, and those encoded data we feed to our system. Okay, those encoded data we feed to our system. So that is how it went. Is coding is must? Some kind of coding is required for cybersecurity, but it's not like everything is going on software that you can go and catch it. Although some kind of coding requirement is there. Now, so suppose somebody sent a plain text. Okay. Now, that secret key, now it's a ciphertext. So basically, it's encrypted text. And then the one who know, they can decrypt that. The one who know, they can decrypt that in the plain method. So that is what, so then welcome method to encrypt that, or we get algorithms to encrypt that things. So that actually happened. These days for login, now we have two things. One is a public key, one is a private key. Public key is something that is anybody can have that access. And nowadays we actually follow two authentication method. So you must have seen in your Google, right? That when you logged into the Google accounts, what happened these days? Things are not in the way that you simply go and logged in. Nowadays, what happened? You have two-way authentication. Two-way authentication means, two-way authentication means first level, you enter a password, and on second level, they ask your, your OTPs, or your, sometime Google pop up something, say, press the number that you want to go with. Like that. So these days, guys, there are a lot of way to do the security, and that's how we have to go with the security of the application, and that's what cybersecurity is all about. So cybersecurity is all about your authentication and restricting the things and safeguard your environment so that nobody can interfere in that, or nobody can enter into the environment. Okay, now this is what about cybersecurity, which I want to tell you today. Now, you guys are open to ask any kind of question, I'll answer you, then we'll close. So, which programming is required? Basically, guys, these days, Pushpak. So basically, we actually do the cybersecurity mainly in the Python. I repeated that thing. Please ping me in the chat. I'm unable to unmute you. The webinar. The name is coming as webinar, who have raised the hand. I request you to put in the chat. I don't have permission to unmute any one of you. So mainly Python. So for cybersecurity, if I say you to learn any language, then learn Python. Although there are a lot of networking things are there, like CCNA or CNN, there are a lot of things are there that you can go with, but the best, if you're talking about by programming, then you have to go with the Python. Any other question? Any other question, guys? So in short, I say that guys, start looking into the cybersecurity. Why it's important? Because you know, this field is having a vast opening these days, and my recommendation is go with that. But if you still think like, no, I don't want to go there, I want to go to programming, then it's your choice. You can choose anything, but choose it wisely. And I'll tell you one more thing. So there's a one YouTube channel which I have, which is owned by me itself. So those guys which are preparing for the interviews and specifically looking for some interview things, so I recommend you guys to say go with this one YouTube channel. Subscribe this. Basically, this is not having any kind of tutorial. This particular channel was meant for the purpose of interviews. Those who are actually looking for some coding or some coding kind of test and not looking for the interview perspective, I recommend to go with this one, because here you will get a topic very specific to the interview, so that and all the latest things that are going in market are here. All the latest topics that are going in markets are here. So it's good you go there and read on this. I'll share the link. So I recommend to people to subscribe for those who are actually looking for the interview perspective. Why is so hard to decrypt even the current trending software decrypt the key of network? Nobody, it's not very easy. So the one MD5 hash. So if I simply say one hashing algorithm MD5, very basic one. If I say decrypt MD5 hash, I'm telling you it's not very easy to decrypt that. So people do double MD5. So how you decrypt that? So it's not, although everything is hackable, right? If something is having a security up to raise to N, then Google Cloud or say Apple Cloud never get hacked, right? Everything have the breakdown, but these kind of hashings algorithm that you write are not very easy to decrypt. Although nothing is impossible. Point is like that. Everything is decrypt. Everything can be done in the way, but not like everything is very easy. I'm telling you, it's not like everything is very straight. Everything is decryptable, buddy. Everything is possible, but up to some level only, not up to n number of extent. Got it? Any other question, anyone? Fine. So here we'll stop, and I recommend that guys go there on the meetup. So the next webinar that we're going to have are more interesting webinars. Pushpak, yeah, tell me, buddy, what you're asking. So very interesting webinars are coming in a picture. Those who are looking for the machine learning, the webinar for machine learning, for Python, AWS, a lot of webinars are coming, and multiple people are training, taking these webinars. So I'll recommend you to go there and start looking for the webinar of your interest, guys. Anything else I can help you with? Any question, anyone? Programming versus coding difference? No, I don't think any difference in that. The two different word, similar word, if you do the coding also, programming also, that's the kind of the same thing, buddy. I don't find the word wise the different. You say if you're doing a back end, the programming, when you're doing a front end, the coding is not like that. I don't think like it's like that. So they're not different. So ideally you're trying to achieve the same motive, either do a coding or programming. Same thing, buddy. Okay. Cool. I think you guys have no doubt, no more doubt. So I'm also done. So cool, guys. So this is just starting, and now going forward, subscribe that and you'll get a lot of things. Does the link to join get saved in somewhere? Yeah, on the YouTube, you'll find the videos on this, buddy. On our Edureka YouTube channel. So if you're going for cyber security, data analytics can be there, but choose one. Don't go in multiple directions, Pushpak. Cool, guys. So I think we are done. Thanks a lot for joining, and hope to see you soon in some other sessions. And we'll do the lot of things going forward this complete week, not this week, I mean this month and going coming months. Okay.